In this video, I'm going to bring together two of my previous projects into one glorious new solution. I've taken the ultrasonic motion sensor that I built using ESPHome, repackaged it, and used it to help solve a problem of how to know when to let the dog out to do her doggy business. Before I go into the technical details, I'm going to give you a bit of background on what the problem is and why I'm doing this. I think it's important to know that creating sensors and things is great fun, but unless you manage to find an actual real-world use for them, then they're probably just going to sit at the back of a cupboard somewhere. Cast your mind back to the video I made about how I get alerts when the dog needs to go out. Actually, you won't be able to cast your mind back because nobody has really seen that video. It's sitting there at the bottom of the charts because no one cares about cute little puppy dogs, it seems. I used an IKEA motion sensor paired with a door contact sensor and a couple of automations to alert me when motion at the back door was detected and the door was shut. This solution is still in place and works really well, but there is a problem. That back door is my conservatory, and given the increasing cost of heating, we'd quite like to keep the conservatory door closed off from the rest of the house this winter. So now the dog will go to the dining room door, which leads to the conservatory, and I won't get notified. Now, I can't just stick a PIR motion sensor in that room by the door because its field of view would be really wide. It'll just pick up motion every time anyone goes anywhere near the door, like during meal times, that sort of thing. What I need is something far more precise, like one of those laser beams you see in the Mission Impossible movies that points across the doorway and alerts me when the beam is broken. Well, I don't have a laser, but what I do have is an ultrasonic sensor, so I can use a beam of sound instead of a beam of light. These things are designed to detect how close something is. Now, if you think about it, if you place one of these sensors pointing across a doorway at the wall on the opposite side, it should always report the same distance value. Until something comes in between the sensor and the wall, then the distance value will drop. Onto the sensor then. This is almost exactly the same as the ultrasonic motion sensor, only this time I've renamed the sensor entities and adjusted a few values. Starting with the hardware, I'm going to open it up here. I've used a D1 Mini and an HCSR04 ultrasonic sensor that I've got a bit of tape over there to stop it coming in contact with the metal on the D1 Mini. There's a few DuPont cables here with the ends cut off and a nice slim project case. This project case, you can see I've made a couple of holes in it as neat as I'm able to for the ultrasonic transmit and receive to poke out, and another little hole on the bottom of it for the USB cable to poke out. The wiring diagram is also identical to the motion sensor wiring. This time though, I've directly soldered the wires to the components in order to save some space and use the most compact enclosure possible. Well, here's the code. I've called mine the dining room brake beam sensor, but you can change yours to whatever you like, of course. I'm going to scroll down to the first thing you need to change, which is here down on line 38, this maximum distance value. Now, this needs to be set to just slightly under the actual distance between the sensor and the wall opposite it. When the distance reading drops below this value that you're setting here, the brake beam sensor, which used to be the motion sensor, is triggered. Now, to start with, it really doesn't matter what you put in here. Upload the code, get the sensor working, stick it in place, and then check the logs. In the logs, you'll see the distance value it's reporting to a few decimal places. Choose a value a few centimetres less than this for your maximum distance, because that value will bounce around a bit due to sensor interference and inaccuracies. You can see here mine's reporting 0.83 metres. Once you know the value you need, edit the YAML again with the required value and reinstall it to your device. The second thing I want to point out is right down here at the bottom, the delayed off value. This here, you can see I've got it 120 seconds. You want your sensor to detect the beam being broken very quickly, but certainly in my case, I don't want to keep getting alerted every couple of seconds that the dog is sniffing around the door. I want to get alerted once and given the chance to actually get up and sort it. This value here sets how long you want the sensor to stay on for after motion has stopped being detected. I found that about 2 minutes is good for me in this situation, but your preferences might vary. Just change this to whatever suits you the best. And this is what you'll be presented with in Home Assistant. You'll get a sensor entity reporting the distance and another binary sensor that shows on or off depending on whether the beam has been broken or not. I've stuck the sensor to the door frame and run the cable behind the dog's crate to the nearest power socket. I'm quite fortunate that it's reasonably easy to hide the cable here and that there was a convenient power socket outlet nearby. The sensor is pointing at a slight angle to the opposite wall to make sure it captures the dog's nose more easily. Right then, you have your sensor all up and running, but there's a final piece to the puzzle. You don't want to be alerted every time anyone walks through that door, do you? Well, perhaps you do, in which case you're all done. But in my scenario, I only want this to alert me if the door is shut, because I need to open it. No point getting alerted if it's already open. I fitted a little sewn-off Zigbee door sensor to the sliding door and combined that with an automation in Home Assistant. The automation is basically exactly the same as the one from my original Let the Dog Out video, so I'm going to point you in the direction of that video and article to see those details. Anyway, the result is that I can now keep my dining room door shut, stopping all of that heat escaping through the conservatory's glass roof, but still get alerted whenever the dog needs to be let out. Puddles avoided. I will stick a parts list in the description below, and as always I'll put the full details, wiring diagram and YAML code up on my website, and there will be a link in the description to that too. I hope you liked this video, and if you did, then please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching, goodbye.